everyone, welcome to Catholic Daily Readings. I'm Andrew Milken. Today is Thursday, July 23rd, 2020. Let's start with a prayer in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord, help us to be pure of heart and to listen to your word with patient minds. Amen. A reading from the book of Jeremiah. This word of the Lord came to me. Go, cry out this message for Jerusalem to hear. I remember the devotion of your youth, how you loved me as a bride, following me in the desert in a land unsown. Sacred to the Lord was Israel, the first fruits of his harvest. Should any presume to partake of them, evil would befall them, says the Lord. When I brought you into the garden, land to eat its goodly fruits, you entered and defiled my land. You made my heritage loathsome. The priests ask not, where is the Lord? Those who dealt with the law knew me not. The shepherds rebelled against me. The prophets prophesied by Baal and went after useless idols. Be amazed at this, O heavens, and shudder with my sheer horror, says the Lord. Two evils have my people done. They have forsaken me, the source of living waters. They have dug themselves cisterns, broken cisterns that hold no water. The word of the Lord. Responsorial Psalm. Please respond, with you is the fountain of life, O Lord. With you is the fountain of life, O Lord. O Lord, your mercy reaches to heaven, your faithfulness to the clouds. Your justice is like the mountains of God, your judgments like the mighty deep. With you is the fountain of life, O Lord. How precious is your mercy, O God. The children of men take refuge in the shadow of your wings. They have their fill of the prime gifts of your house. From your delightful stream you give them to drink. With you is the fountain of life, O Lord. For with you is the fountain of life, and in your light we see light. Keep up your mercy toward your friends, your just defense of the upright of heart. With you is the fountain of life, O Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. Blessed are you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth. You have revealed to the little ones the mysteries of the kingdom. Alleluia, alleluia. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. The disciples approached Jesus and said, Why do you speak to the crowd in parables? He said to them in reply, Because knowledge of the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven has been granted to you, but to them it has not been granted. To anyone who has, more and more will be given, and he will grow rich. From anyone who has not, even what he has will be taken away. This is why I speak to them in parables, because they look but do not see, and hear, but do not listen or understand. Isaiah's prophecy is fulfilled in them, which says, You shall indeed hear, but not understand. You shall indeed look, but never see. Gross is the heart of this people. They will hardly hear with their ears. They have closed their eyes, lest they see with their eyes, and hear with their ears, and understand with their hearts and be converted, and I heal them. But blessed are your eyes because they see, and your ears because they hear. Amen, I say to you, many prophets and righteous people long to hear what you see but did not see it, and to hear what you hear but did not hear it. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Is it possible to look but not see, to listen but not understand? Of course it is. The scribes and Pharisees are one example that do it all the time. They look at the Son of God but don't believe it is him. They hear his words but don't truly understand. That's what Jesus means by looking but not seeing or hearing but not understanding. This is the reason that Jesus speaks in parables. Parables are a way that Jesus explains what he is saying instead of just saying it. Because, as he states, his disciples have been given the ability to understand what Jesus is saying without the use of parables, but others haven't. I want you to think about this. Are you trying to believe what Jesus said? Or are you letting it go in one ear and out the other? Pray to God, and he will give you faith to interpret his word correctly and understand what he teaches. That's my meditation for today. If you liked it, please like and subscribe. That's all for today. I'm Andrew Milliken saying, live life in Christ together.